disks in YoungStellar objects are usually related to outflows that are also observed. And when we observe them in the optical, they are very prominent. They have been first detected in the 50s by Herbig and Haro, where he saw small patches of optical emission, which is the result of fast shocks, where these very fast outflows collided with the ambient medium, heated the material, and produced this very hot gas that produced H-alpha emission here. And later, with better resolution, we could also identify condensations, knots of denser material along the jets that are aligned in linear structures, bipolar linear structures. And here in this beautiful image, we have two examples. So the first is here. We have this bipolar outflow in the two directions. Here's the central object. And we see on one side here how the shock wave from where the jet collides with the ambient molecular cloud. The second example is here, where we also have this bipolar structure, and we have here this bow shock, and we have here this bow shock. What we also observe when we go in somewhat closer is that we have a series of condensations here that correspond to episodic events in the history of the jet. So either collisions of material here locally with the dense gas or particularly strong outflow events that travel along the jet, and the distance here indicates the time between these events. These bipolar outflows, Herbig-Haro objects, are typical structures in these low mass star forming processes. They are producing very strong shocks, and typical velocities are a few hundred kilometers per second. This is already so fast that when we observe such an outflow over a longer period of time, it is possible to observe how the knots, these clearly visible structures, move over time. Here first we have a zoom in. Again, we have here the central object somewhere, and then we have here this shock structure of this bipolar outflow. This is an example of such a time series of observations over 13 years, so from 1994 to 2007. And we see how these structures here move further away from the central source, which is here. So we can observe here basically directly the dynamic of the jet. We can also look at outflows in the radio. Here we then look at molecular line emission. And in the radio, these jets are much less narrow. They are much less confined, but the green contours here show you how these jets look in the radio. This is emission by the CO molecule. And the interpretation here is that this jet basically is carrying away the molecular material from the ambient molecular cloud and produces this wider angle outflow, this molecular outflow. So the momentum of the jet is transported to the molecular material, which then moves also in a bipolar fashion with much lower velocity. So instead of hundreds, it's maybe tens of kilometers per second. However, due to the large mass, the bulk It carries the bulk of the outflow momentum. So in these orders here. So this is again not the directly ejected material from the Young Stellar source, but the ambient gas that's being swept up.